أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Some of us sometimes don't pay special attention to our prayers. In fact, sometimes we might give our prayers little attention, such that you'll find a person favoring all of his activities over prayer. He might still pray before the time of prayer is up, but he will delay it and make sure to perform all of his activities before he stands on his prayer mat and turns to his Lord in prayer. Hence, tonight we want to share a tradition with you about belittling prayer and the deadly effects, or say the terrible and negative effects that belittling prayer has. The point behind this is to remind ourselves of the importance of prayer and the danger of belittling it. Hopefully, the tradition we shall read will instill an amount of fear in our hearts, positive fear, fear that will push us to grow spiritually and to fix or strengthen our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The tradition can be found in a book called Falah al-Sa'il by Sayyid ibn Tawus rahmatullah alayh. He mentions that the Lady of Light Fatima salawatullahi alayha is narrated to have said, how beautiful is it to mention the Lady of Light alayha salatu wassalam, the Lady of Purity in the pure month of Ramadan. What has she said, salamullah alayha? She is narrated to have said that she asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, Ya abatah, ma liman tahawana bi salatih min al-rijali wal nisa. She told the Prophet, O Father, what will happen to a man or a woman who belittles his or her prayer? The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, Ya Fatima, man tahawana bi salatihi min al-rijali wa al-nisa' ibtalahu Allahu bi 15 khaslah. He told her, O Fatima, when a man or a woman belittles his or her prayer, that individual will be afflicted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with 15 different hardships, or say 15 different effects. He says, Sittun minha fi dar ad-dunya. 6 of these hardships or effects will take place in this world. وثلاثٌ عند موته. 3 will take place at the time of that person's death. وثلاثٌ في قبره. 3 will take place when that person is placed in his or her grave. وَثَلَاثٌ فِي الْقِيَامَةِ إِذَا خَرَجَ مِنْ قَبْرِهِ. And 3 will take place. 3 will take place when that person comes out of his grave on the Day of Judgment. Let us listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَأَمَّا اللَّوَاتِ تُصِيبُهُ فِي دَارِ الدُّنْيَا. He says, as for the hardships or effects that he will be afflicted with in this world, they are the following. فَالْأُولَى يَرْفَعُ اللَّهُ الْبَرَكَةَ مِنْ عُمْرِهِ. The first effect is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove blessing from that person's lifespan. The removal of blessing implies what? It implies that not much benefit will stem from that person's lifespan. We say this because when something benefits others abundantly, it's considered to be what? It's considered to be blessed. Take the example of Tasbih al-Zahra alayha salam. From the day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi taught Lady Fatima that Tasbih, there have been people performing Tasbih al-Zahra on earth. Up until today, millions and millions of people have performed that Tasbih. And millions of people will perform it in the future, up until the day of judgment. Which means this one Tasbih, which consists of 100 words, 34 times Allahu Akbar, 33 times Alhamdulillah, and 33 times Subhanallah, has benefited a lot of people, waves and waves of people, by granting them what? Granting them waves of good deeds and helping them self-build as they battle their arch enemy, the devil. Hence, this tasbih is considered to be blessed. But how could it not be blessed when it is the tasbih of Al-Mubarakah, the blessed lady, Fatima salawatullah alayha. So the Prophet says, the first effect that will take place in this world, the first effect out of the six effects that take place in this world when a person belittles his prayer, is removal of blessing from his lifespan. Then he said, وَيَرْفَعُ اللَّهُ الْبَرَكَةَ فِي رِزْقِهِ مِنْ رِزْقِهِ. And Allah Ta'ala will remove blessing from that person's sustenance. وَيَمْحُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ سِيمَاءَ الصَّالِحِينَ مِنْ وَجْهِهِ. He says, and Allah Ta'ala will erase the sign of the righteous from that person's face. What's he saying here? Realize, when you're righteous, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves a certain mark or a certain effect on your face, such that when people see you, they can tell that this person is righteous. That mark, that effect, say that spiritual mark or effect will be erased from that person's face. Because he's belittling what? The pole of the religion. Salat, prayer. These are three effects. What are the other three? He says, وَكُلُّ عَمَلٍ يَعْمَلُهُ لَا يُجَرْ عَلَيْهِ. Every deed he performs in this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not reward him for those deeds. This is not surprising, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi has said what? The Prophet has said that if prayer is accepted, the rest of our deeds will be accepted. And if prayer is rejected, the rest of our deeds will be rejected. So when a person belittles prayer, what happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not prepare a reward for that person, a reward for the deeds committed by that person. Then he says, وَلَا يَرْتَفَعْ دُعَاؤُهُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ. The fifth effect that happens in this world is that the supplication of that person, the person who belittles prayer, will not ascend to the sky. When the Prophet says the supplication will not ascend to the sky, this implies that this person's supplication won't be answered. Here, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is uncovering a new secret to us pertaining to dua. Why don't our supplications get answered sometimes? The Prophet is telling you. Sometimes the problem lies in what? In prayer. As in, it's because the person is belittling his prayer. Hence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala isn't answering his supplication. The sixth effect is, وَالسَّادِسَ لَيْسَ لَهُ حَظٌ فِي دُعَاءِ الصَّالِحِينَ. The sixth effect is, that person won't be mentioned by the righteous when they supplicate. You know, the righteous people supplicate for their fellow brothers and sisters in faith. Because this person belittles his salat, the righteous people won't mention him in their prayers, meaning in their supplications. Which could mean that possibly they'll forget to mention him because of belittling prayer. Then he says, وَأَمَّا اللَّوَاتِي تُصِيبُهُ عِنْدَ مَوْتِهِ. As for the hardships or effects that afflict him upon his death, فَأُولَاهُنَّ أَنَّهُ يَمُوتُ ذَلِيلًا. The first hardship or effect is that he will die as he is humiliated. He will die as he feels humility. وَالثَّانِيَ يَمُوتُ جَائِعًا. The second effect is that he will die hungry. وَالثَّالِثَ يَمُوتُ عَطْشَانًا. The third effect is that he will die thirsty. يَمُوتُ عَطْشَانًا فَلَوْ سُقِيَ مِنْ أَنْهَارِ الدُّنْيَا لَمْ يُرْوَى عَطَشُهُ. The Prophet says that he will be thirsty, and even if people bring him water from the rivers of this world, from the different rivers of this world, and give him that water, even if he drinks that water, he'll still be thirsty. He won't quench his thirst. Here, I want to make a side note. Realize Rasulullah isn't saying that everyone who dies thirsty and or hungry belittles his prayer. He's not saying this. Rather, he's saying if someone belittles his prayer, he'll die thirsty and hungry. There are certain people who die thirsty or hungry because they're oppressed. Abu Dharr rahmatullah alayh died out of starvation because he was oppressed. I believe there's a special someone that you're remembering right now who also left this world when he was thirsty and hungry. And that was Abu Abdullah al-Husayn salawatullahi alayh. But Abu Abdullah never belittled his prayer. Abu Abdullah didn't only pray. Abu Abdullah was the embodiment of prayer. And if it wasn't for him, today there would be no such thing as Salat or Siyam. He is the one who preserved the religion of God through his ultimate sacrifice and his pure blood that was spilled in the land of Karbala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alih, the Prophet is telling us he who belittles his prayer will die thirsty and hungry. But he's not telling you everyone who dies thirsty and hungry necessarily belittles his prayer. Please understand that point. Then he said, وَأَمَّا اللَّوَاتِ تُصِيبُهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ. As for the effects or hardships that will afflict him when he is in his grave, فَأُولَاهُنَّ يُوكِلُ اللَّهُ بِهِ مَلَكًا يُزَعِجُهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ. The first effect is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will authorize an angel to come to that person's grave and bother him. So there will be an angel who is constantly bothering that individual. وَثَانِيَ يُضَيِّقْ عَلَيْهِ قَبْرَهِ. The second effect is that his grave will be tight. Allah Ta'ala will tighten his grave upon him. The third effect, وَالثَّالِثَ تَكُونُ الظُّلْمَةُ فِي قَبْرِهِ. The third effect is that his grave will be dark. It's enough to be alone in that grave, but to be in a tight grave that's dark is a greater calamity. Hence we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to widen our graves and to fill our graves with light and to make us the companions of Ahlul Bayt salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhim as we live through the world of purgatory, barzakh. Then he said, وَأَمَّا اللَّوَاتِي تُصِيبُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِذَا خَرَجَ مِنْ قَبْرِهِ. As for the effects or hardships that will afflict him on the Day of Judgment when he comes out of his grave, فَأُولَاهُنَّ أَنْ يُوكِلَ اللَّهُ بِهِ مَلَكًا يَسْحَبُهُ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ وَالْخَلَائِقْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَيْهِ. The first effect is that Allah Ta'ala will authorize an angel to go to that person and to drag him on the ground of the Day of Judgment, as his face will be on the ground, and as the people and the creations present on that day will be looking at that individual. Do you know what that means? It means he doesn't only receive a physical punishment, he also receives an emotional punishment. He gets treated in an awful manner. He feels disrespected. He feels that he is being humiliated. Then he says, alayhi salam wa alihi, وَالثَّانِيَ يُحَاسَبْ حِسَابًا شَدِيدًا. The second effect that will happen on that day is that Allah Ta'ala will reckon him in a difficult manner. His reckoning will be difficult. It will be tough and exhausting. You see, when Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala reckons people on that day, when He questions them, sometimes the questioning will be easy. For some people, it will be easy. As in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't be very detailed with them in His questions, Azza wa Jal. Whereas, for some, Allah Azza wa Jal will be very detailed in His questions. He will be very strict in His questions. To give you an idea on how the hisab, the reckoning, might be very tough, take the following example. Imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to ask us about what we did in every minute in our lives. How long would our hisab be? If he wanted to ask you about every minute, let alone every second, how long would our hisab, would our reckoning be? It would be very long, very difficult, and very exhausting. If you don't want to be from those who are afflicted with a difficult reckoning, make sure that you don't belittle the prayer. Then the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, وَالثَّالِثَ لَا يَنْظُرُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِ وَلَهُ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. He said, and the third effect or hardship that will afflict that person on the Day of Judgment is that Allah Ta'ala won't gaze at him. Gazing at him in this context means what? It means Allah Ta'ala won't show him special care. You see, Allah sees everyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees everyone. But does He look at you? As in, does He show you special care or not? That's a different story. That person will be deprived from Allah's care because he belittled prayer in this world. Then he said, وَلَا يُزَكِّيهِ. So the Prophet is saying, Allah Ta'ala won't purify that person on the Day of Judgment. Or he's saying, Allah Ta'ala won't praise him, which implies that God won't be happy with him. You know, when you're happy with someone, you praise him, right? You say you're a good fellow, well done, etc. Allah Ta'ala won't praise that individual. He won't purify him and or praise him. On top of all of these effects, he receives what? A painful punishment on the Day of Judgment. The Prophet says, وَلَهُ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And he shall receive a painful punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from belittling prayer and make us from those who pay attention to their prayers, ameliorate their prayers as much as possible, and uphold a strong relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, brothers and sisters, prayer is essential. Prayer is essential. If we want to reach high levels of perfection in the eyes of God subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to pay attention to our prayers. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa sallallahu ala al-mustafa Muhammadin wa alihi al-tahireen.